This is the Sunrise Feed Mill from the Walthers Company in their Cornerstone series. This was actually suggested by a viewer, and at first I kind of dismissed it because I think it's very difficult to make plastic kits look as good as wood kits. But then I started thinking about exactly why that is, and maybe I'd like to actually take a shot at a plastic kit and see what I can do with it. And I also had realized this was actually on one of my wish lists, so I had thought about it before. So I decided to give it a shot. So let's see what we can do with it. Upon first inspection, the quality of this kit was pretty disappointing. That's really not to knock Walthers. They have a market that they're going for. A lot of people want to just put together buildings pretty quickly without a lot of skills, and I have no problem with that. But in this particular kit, the roof was pretty poor, and the loading dock was pretty poor, and the doors were pretty poor. So I was kind of hoping it was going to be a little bit better than it was. But it is a pretty simple kit to put together. The building structure itself is a clapboard building on a concrete base. And as I said, the loading dock doors were pretty poor. So the first thing I want to do is remove the loading dock doors. And for that, I'm using a Dremel tool with a cutting disc. And this actually turned out to be pretty easy to get these out. There's four doors total. Now, if you don't want to take a Dremel tool to your kit, one thing you can do to add some character to the doors is just to glue some strip lumber over the doors in kind of a Z bracing pattern. And I actually did that for the smaller door. So I left the smaller door intact and just added some bracing to it, and it looked pretty good. This is probably not a recommended way to use the razor saw. Another trick that some people recommend is to use a razor saw to scrape the clapboard walls to add some wood grain. So I'm giving that a try here. I'm not entirely sure I was that happy with the effect. Also with the Dremel, I used the burr bit to do some gouging in the concrete base. In one section of the building, I used the cutting disc to remove a section of the clapboard, and I'm going to fill that back in with the studs so it looks like the clapboard has rotten away or fallen away. With the Dremel work done, I'm doing some cleanup around the doors with an X-Acto knife and an emery board. Somehow I managed to do this without stabbing myself. In the areas where I gouged out the concrete, I'm using some Vallejo ground texture to add some aggregate texture to the concrete. This is an acrylic product that has just kind of a gritty texture to it. They have several different ground texture products, so here specifically I'm using the gray sand. Now I'm using some scale lumber to recreate the large loading doors. There's nothing fancy here, just whatever design you want to come up with, and in fact, all four doors turned out to be slightly different. If you're willing to take the Dremel tool to your kit, I think this is a pretty worthwhile modification, and it does allow you the option of leaving the doors open. One of the curious things about the large loading doors on the kit is they are not the same ones that are pictured on the box art. I left the smaller door intact, so here I'm using an X-Acto knife to remove the rail that it slides on and also to add some imperfections. I'm going to add some strip lumber as bracing in kind of a Z pattern. Here's the wall where I cut out a section of the clapboard. I added some joists using scale lumber, and now I'm gluing in a piece of cardboard to indicate the interior wall. I'm trying to achieve an effect similar to what you see in this picture of this old house. I first sprayed the wall pieces with Tamiya primer, and then I used an airbrush to paint various colors. It really started out as Vallejo concrete, and then over top of that, I added some Vallejo dirt, and I just kept pouring colors into the airbrush, and the last color was kind of a Vallejo light gray, sort of just a mixed kind of cloud pattern across the walls. And now I am adding a wash of Vallejo dark gray wash, and this is the very intense black wash that I like to use a lot. After the wash had dried, I did some dry brushing of Vallejo silver gray. The main wall color is Folk Art Thunder Gray, and I'm applying that with a sponge. And I've been kind of hesitant to try and use the sponge and the cheap paint on plastic because I just didn't think it was going to absorb very well. But it didn't seem to be a problem, really. And now we come to the roof pieces. So these roof pieces are pretty bad, and when I first looked at them, I couldn't even figure out what kind of a roof they were trying to model. So then I decided it was probably strips of tar paper. So there's a technique that you can use where you take construction paper, paint it gray, and then paint it black, and then sand through the black to reveal the gray, and that gives a nice worn look of tar paper. So I thought I would try that with these pieces. So I spray painted it gray, and then I spray painted it black, and now I'm sanding through the black to reveal some of the gray. And honestly, it looks pretty good. I was surprised at how good it was going to look. So I'm using 220 grit sandpaper, and I'm wrapping it in just a Tamiya sanding sponge because it makes it easier to hold. And then just kind of sanding through the colors, and that reveals the gray on the edges. So I think this looks pretty good, all things considered, and I thought about using these as the roof pieces, but then I just decided to build the roof myself. If you don't want to scratch build a roof, I think this is a technique worth trying. Here are my four loading dock doors, and the first thing I'm doing is painting them with Folk Art barn wood. For the windows, I first sprayed them with Tamiya gray primer, and then I gave them a black wash, and now I'm going to paint them with Folk Art vintage white using a sponge. The loading dock in this kit is pretty bad, so I'm going to build my own, and before I do that, I'm going to cut off the part of the base that supports the loading dock. This will make it easier to put scenery under the loading dock. Now it's time to start assembly of the building, and you might notice that I added some decals. I originally tried to put on one of the decals from the kit, and it broke apart into pieces when I pulled it out of the water. I don't know that I followed the directions correctly, but I've had that happen in the past with Walthers kits. So what I decided to do is, for this building, I decided to make it a feed store that has been turned into a strip club and is then abandoned. And so I put on some strip club decals that I got from Dave's Decals. I decided to rebuild the supports for the awning out of scale lumber, although I don't think this was really necessary because I don't think they're particularly visible. But I thought it was a detail worth trying. I kind of decided at the last minute that I would use a trim color on this building, so here I'm painting the windows with Americana Victorian blue. This blue is a little more vibrant than I would like, but at this point I'm committed to it, so I was going to live with it. Trim color on this particular building is a little more complicated because now I have to mask off the window trim and paint those as well. The loading dock doors are also going to get the trim color. This was a fair amount of work, and I think it makes the building look better, but it seems like a pretty fancy feed store to have this blue trim on it. In one corner of the building, I had completely gouged out the concrete base, and now I'm filling it back in with some milliput. This is a epoxy putty, two parts that you mix together, and it seems to work pretty well for this. Unfortunately, the corner that I gouged out butts up against the other part of the building, so I should have picked a better corner. The milliput smooths out easily with a wet sculpting tool. Once the putty sets, I will also cover it with the same Vallejo ground texture to give the appearance of exposed aggregate in the concrete. Even though the paint I did on the roof I thought was pretty decent, I decided to rebuild the whole roof from scratch. So here I'm cutting out sections from a cereal box cardboard. I decided to scratch build two loading docks. One loading dock matches the dimensions of the one that came with the kit, so here I'm setting the width and I'm using the chopper to cut the pieces. The other loading dock I used following the template that was in the Fine Scale Miniatures Hayes & Boyd kit. For this loading dock that's the same dimensions as the one in the kit, I just used my own design, made it up. Whatever you want to do is fine. The loading dock that came with the kit is pretty poorly detailed, so I think building your own really helps the appearance of the kit. The loading dock with the kit is on concrete supports, so if you want to keep your build simple, you could just build the top and still use the concrete supports from the kit. You don't have to build out legs. As I'm adding the boards, I skip a few spaces to give it a little more character and make it look a little more dilapidated. Using washes of acrylic paint on plastic buildings can leave water spots, so I decided to weather the building using washes of artist oils. My colors are black, white, raw umber, and burnt sienna. The disadvantage of the artist oils is that it takes about a week for them to dry before you can do anything else. But the advantage is you have a long time to make changes. After about an hour, you can see what it's going to look like when it dries. Then you still have several days at which you can make changes with a brush dipped in thinner. Before applying the wash, I did spray the building with Tester's Dull Coat Lacquer, just in case the wash was going to do any damage to the acrylic paint underneath. I've never had that problem, but it was better just to be safe. I had some stair stringers left over from a previous project, so I decided to build a couple of staircases for this kit. This was my technique of assembling the stairs. I mount the stringers to the table using blue tack and then start applying the individual steps. Rather than using the window panes that came with the kit, I'm just using pieces of sheet acetate. I'm gluing them in with tester's cement for clear parts. As with other projects, I found some pictures of curtains on the internet and I printed them out at various different sizes, and I'm gluing them in behind the window panes. These particular curtains came from Wayfair.com, which is a pretty good source for pictures of curtains. You might have to do some editing, so I use paint.net, which is a free photo editing program. I decided to board up a couple of the windows to give a little more character to the building. These boards happen to have come from my test of dipping the wood in India ink and alcohol stain mixture. Using India ink mixed with isopropyl alcohol is a common way of weathering wood on model railroad kits. I just haven't used it very much. Because I'm gluing wood to plastic, I'm using super glue gel to attach the boards. In some of my other videos, I showed how you can simulate tar paper roofing by taking black construction paper, spraying it with a gray enamel spray paint, and then spraying over that with a black enamel spray paint. And then you sand through the black paint to reveal the gray paint. This is a technique that came from a video from Jason Jensen. I really like the way it looks, and so I decided to do that for this building. I'm using 220 grit sandpaper wrapped in a Tamiya sanding sponge to make it easier to hold. I'm supporting it on a paint stick that I got from Lowe's. This just helps sand off the edges to give a better appearance. This is my cardboard from a cereal box that I cut to the correct size. I spray painted it black, and then I sprayed it with spray adhesive, and that's how I'm attaching the strips. This building took almost an entire sheet of construction paper to make all the roofing material. It was pretty tedious, but I think the end result was worth it. Although there's a fair amount of work involved, it costs almost nothing to use this technique for the roofing. I haven't seen enough tar paper roof in real life to know how realistic it is, but I think it looks pretty good. I used super glue gel to attach wood blocks to the walls where the roof is going to meet the wall. That way I can use white glue to glue the roof to the wood blocks, but I'm also using a little bit of super glue gel to glue the roof panels directly to the plastic. After the roof panels are in place, I'll put another strip of tar paper along the crown. For the wooden docks, I gave them a wash of Vallejo dark gray, and now I'm dry brushing on Vallejo silver gray. Later on, I'll do some additional weathering with Vallejo slime colors and European splash mud. I'm painting the dust collector using the Vallejo Rust and Steel set. This is a set of acrylic paints, and I'm basically following the instructions for the set. So this starts with a dry brush of burnt umber. After the burnt umber dry brush, I'm adding some rust pigments, and I thin these with paint thinner. Once the paint thinner has set, I'll spray the assembly with Tester's Dull Coat to seal it. The awning roof is from buildersinscale.com. The roof is made of metal. I first sprayed it with Tamiya primer, and then I sprayed it with Tester's Graphite Gray Metallic. This is an enamel spray paint from a can. Now I'm weathering it with rust-colored pigments and paint thinner. A really inexpensive way to enhance the look of this kit is to add rafter tails. It's a fair amount of work. I think it took me about 2 hours total to put rafter tails on the roof. Here I'm painting some strips of scale lumber using the blue trim color. Now I'm attaching the rafter tails using super glue gel. Here I'm attaching the supports that I built for the awning. After the rafter tail glue had dried, I had to go back and paint the ends of the tails. I glued some basswood strips to the bottom of the awning to help keep it straight, so now I'm attaching it to the supports using super glue gel. If you didn't want to buy a third-party product for the awning, you could just build it out of cereal box cardboard and tar paper strips, as I did with the roof. Once I completed the assembly, I applied some weathering powders and then sprayed it with Tester's Dull Coat to seal them. Naturally, the close-ups are going to reveal some flaws, but overall, I'm pretty happy with the way this building turned out. If you're paying attention, you may have noticed that the only parts I used from the kit were basically the walls and the dust collector. I built my own roof and my own loading docks.
Well, I wish I was a catfish swimming in a deep blue sea. I would have all you good-looking women fishing after me, showing up after me. Showing up after me. Hold up. Hold up. Showing up. I went to my baby's house and I sat down on her step. Come on in now, buddy, you know my husband just now left. Showing up just now left. Showing up just now left. Oh, Lord. Oh, well. Oh, well. Well, my